another problem based on the main dimension of DC machine design, right? So first you can read the problem. So the design is required for 50 kilowatts, 4 pole and 600 RPM, 220 volt, a DC shunt generator, the full load terminal voltage, that is a 220 volt. The maximum gap density they are given in our problem, that is the BM, that is the maximum gap density, right? That is the, normally the air gap density, we can mention as Weber per meter square. Here the maximum gap density BM, it should be equal to 0.83 Weber per meter square, that they are given in our problem. Then the ampere conductor per meter, 30,000 ampere conductor per meter. Then assume that the full load armature voltage drop is equal to 3% of rated voltage. The rated voltage they are given. So they are given on assumption full load voltage drop in the armature, it should be equal 3% of voltage, that is the rated voltage. Similarly, the next one assumption, the field current, it should be equal 1% of load current. So that assumption you have to write. Then the ratio of pole core arc to voltage, it should be equal, that is the L by tau, that is the ratio of pole core arc to voltage, it should be equal to 0.67. So ratio of pole core arc and pole core length, both are, it should be same, because it is the generator and square pole faced. And compared with the last problem, here they are not given any efficiency. So whatever the, that is why they are given the voltage drop as well as the variation of field current. Okay, from that you can solve the problem. So as it is, these are all the formulas we are going to use it. But here, compared with the last problem, here they are given the maximum gap density, they are not given BAV. Okay, so that is, that case we need to consider the form factor KF, it should be equal BAV divided by PG, it should be equal L by tau or T by tau, it should be equal 0.67. From this two relationship we can find it out easily BAV value. Okay, then similarly we need to find it out new power value, that is the PA. That means here they are given on power rating, that power is applicable for without drop, right? So we are given the two assumptions, that is the voltage drop as well as the field current. So by using this relationship we need to find it out exact EMF generated in the machine. So that is why we need to consider the voltage drop first. So the VL, it should be equal to 0.03, that is the 3% of rated voltage is 220. From that you can find it out the voltage drop, that is the 6.6 volt. So the E, it should be equal, that is the actual induced EMF or generated EMF, equal the rated voltage plus load voltage drop. That means 220 plus 6.6, that is the 226.6, that is the E value. The EV in the sense, that is the actual generated voltage. Okay, similarly you need to find it out the actual current developed in the, or the actual current flow in the machine. This is the shunt generator, so the armature current, it should be equal sum of field current and load current, because it is the shunt connection. So the armature current, it should be equal the load current plus the field current. So by using this relationship we need to find it out the armature current or developed armature current. Okay, so we know the common formula, the power rating P, it should be equal the rated voltage into the load current. So the rated voltage you know and the power value they are given. From that you can find it out easily IL, that is the load current. And they are given another one assumption, that is the field current, it should be equal 1% of load current. So the 1%, that is the 0.01, and we are found out the load current, that is the 227 ampere. So that you can, from that you can find it out field current, it should be equal 1% in the sense, so 2.27 ampere. So from this you can find it out developed armature current IL, it should be equal IL plus IF. So you can find it out easily IA. So once if you are found out the actual generated voltage and the actual generated current, from that you can find it out easily exact power developed in the armature. It is the generator. So what is the power produced in the armature, that you can find it out directly with the voltage drop, with the additional drop, they are given the assumptions, right? So additional drop, with the additional drop, we are identified the actual generated EMF and the actual generated current. Through that we can find it out easily. PA should be equal to 51.95 kilowatts. That is the PA value, actual generated or developed output voltage. Okay, so we know the output equation and output coefficient. So the output equation is this. That is the PA should be equal to C naught into D square LN, right? That is the DC machine output equation. From that we can easily find it out D and L. So our requirement is diameter and length. So initially we need to find it out C naught, because remaining all value you know, and D square L and C naught we need to find it out. So C naught we have formula. The C naught it should be equal to by square BAV into AC into 10^-3. So you can substitute all the values and you can find it out easily. The BAV value they are not given directly. Through this relationship form factor we can find it out the BAV value. So the BAV value you can substitute directly, then you can find it out output coefficient C naught. Then that value you can substitute in the D square L equation, that is the output equation. From that you can find it out D square L value. Once you are obtained the D square L value, then you can find it out again the L by tau relationship, L in terms of D value you have obtained. So again you can substitute L value in terms of D in the D square L equation. Then you can find the D cube value. From that you can calculate the D value, right? So once if you are identified or obtained the D value, then you can substitute in the previous expression in L in terms of D. So you can find the L value. So the L and D value you are obtained. So that value you can draw the diagram like this, the diameter and length. That is the main dimension for given problem. Okay, that is the diameter and the length. Okay, thank you.